weird, and I'm in no mood for your jive. Do you hear me?
Man, I'm not playing. Get out of here, or I'm kicking your ethereal ass.
Ethereal? I don't even know what that means.
Welcome back to Gear Chat. Yeah. Welcome back to Gear Chat University.
Sorry about that, y'all. Damn, I'm talking from deep. Welcome back. Now I'm too loud. Welcome back. Welcome back, Chachi. Yay. Welcome back to Gear Chat University. I am John G, the El Capitan. Yes, school is in session. We are in a pandemic. Shit's crazy. But check it out. I got something for you. Ooh-wee, we got a barn burner, baby. First up. Let's go with the Bastille. You know Bastille, the micro granny and all of that stuff. Well, they got a joint out and it's a MIDI looper. Bastille has a MIDI looper. I repeat, a MIDI looper. Just the thought of that, I'm like, okay, when I first saw it, I'm like, all right, because I don't think anybody else has that out where it's just, I know you can essentially do that with like the Octatrack or the Deluge, you know, through MIDI. I believe the Deluge can do it. I believe the Octatrack can do it right through MIDI. You can loop something, but to have a small box that's dedicated just for MIDI looping, I believe it does some other interesting things besides just looping, I want to say. I'm not an expert on it by any means, but definitely go check it out. Bastille, B-A-S-T-L, has a MIDI looper. The makers of the Micro Granny sampler and a few other things that are actually pretty dope. So go check that out, man. I think that is a nice piece of gear that could, just the thought of it, I'm thinking like that could be slick, especially with hardware gear. So yeah, especially if it does some other things other than just looping. I believe it does have some other characteristics. I don't know if it's play mode or what, but I believe it does some other things other than just looping, or along with looping rather. Next up, I saw this, I was like, okay, which, let's go down this rabbit hole. Personas has a sequencer out, and it's called the Atom SQ. It's a MIDI sequencer going for $249, hot $250. Now it's a small box, maybe a little bit longer than a Voca, not quite the length of two Vocas, you know, put side by side, but damn near, it's about that size. And it has like, you know, pads where you can perform, and you know, also with the TR style sequencer where you can, you know, use it as a sequencer, or you can perform on it. Now, the thing about it is it's immediately designed to work with Studio One. So if you plug it in and it has 100% integration out of the box. Now, it will work with Ableton, I believe, immediately. It can work with any DAW, but I'm imagining that it will work, but other DAWs, it may be some things about it that you either will not be able to program, or it may not have that complete integration. So you will be able to use it, but it may not be 100%, which lead me to the whole thought that, well, it makes sense that, you know, like Push is a dedicated controller for Ableton, you know, so why wouldn't somebody come out and make a dedicated controller just like Fire, just like Ableton did Fire for Fruity Loops or FL Studio. Studio One. Now, so the rabbit hole for me is how long is it before, what's the other app that people are using? I don't know how much traction either one of these one has, but Studio One and the one that I was using, Beat, let me pull it up real quick. It's Beat something. What is it? Beatmaker 2. So Will somebody make a controller for Beatmaker 2? It only stands to reason that, you know what I mean? So that's the rabbit hole I'm at. And the day comes when Korg makes, or somebody, even if it's not Korg, if somebody makes a controller that is dedicated to work with Korg gadgets, this could be like the new thing to make a hardware dedicated to integrate 100% with a software that already exists. And so this is really territory that's been there all along. This lane has been there. It's not new per se. It's been there. It's just a matter of someone going, wait a minute, hey, just like Push. I mean, Push is how old now? You know what I mean? So yeah, so I thought that was interesting that I saw that, and that is integrated directly or specifically with Studio One, which led me to think, well, will they? Okay, next up we have Arturia, stay killing the game. Shouts out to you. Arturia has the new key step 37. Now they just came out with the key step pro, which I thought was dope. I definitely looking at it and I'm thinking like, yeah, that's probably gonna, yeah, I feel like I'm gonna have that. Now they just came up with the second generation of the key step, not 37. The other one was 35, I want to say. No, 32, maybe. And they added 5 keys. So, yeah, now this one is the 37. So, one more octave, or not even a full octave, I don't think. But I basically think they tried to add, or maybe there was enough. I don't know. I'm rambling now. But either an octave they added, basically they added 5 keys. So, I believe octave is 7. However, maybe those two were already there. I don't know. What's that math? 28. Yeah, there it is. 28. 30. So it's 4 extra. So then 37. So yeah, they added an octave, basically. Whatever. So with that, I think Arturia, I mean, everybody already had the first, what was it called? The first key step. Now the key step pro drop. More than likely, not everybody, but that's going to garnish a nice amount of attention from us. Then you add in this one. Now, I do believe the first one is you're going to see a increase in sales on Reverb. Those about to go through because everybody's going to, I imagine, people will kind of get rid of those to buy this new one that's now got the added. Not only does it have the added keys, but it has the added, added CV gates or whatever, or CV controls, dedicated controls. So go check that out. $169 is the price point. Another reason why they're killing it. The pricing is right at $169. I think it's going to do well, just like the original. It did well. I believe this will do very well. Okay. Now, here's what I really want to get to. I saw this today and I was like, uh-oh, because this company, as far as I'm concerned, they came out of nowhere. So my story is I was, you know, in the music. I came in the game late anyway. I missed the MPC. When I came in, it was the Electribe. That's my MPC. So I got into it, was doing music for a minute, got serious, making some stuff, some shit happened, left music for some years. When I come back, you know, because the feeling of making music never really dies, or it never really died. But then I just like, well, stop doing it. So then I'm kind of like sitting there, you know, in that itch. It started like, man, I can feel it. Like I need to do it. I need something is in me needs to come out. So now I'm like, all right, I started searching. So now I'm back into looking at the magazines, or now it's online. And I'm like, man, okay. What's machine? What's this? All right. Well, first it was the beat thing. I'm like, what is this? Okay. So that was kind of out when I got back into it. So the beat thing was a thing. And so machine had come into it. What is this? All right. So, you know, at this point, it's the NPC killer. You're hearing that thing going around. And at this point, NPC has had a drought, if you will, because the Renaissance was, you know, it got kind of like some bad reviews because it wasn't standalone, because it was essentially a controller. And they tried to not, even though it said it right there, they tried to mark it as if it wasn't, but it really was, type of thing. And so I remember that being a real big thing at one point. So machine, like I said, they came into the game late, or came into existence as far as I'm concerned, and in the timeline, they just kind of, here we are, machine. So I prepped that, or preferenced that, to say, now they have the standalone joint, right? It's called the Machine Plus. Machina, for those that like to pronounce it that way. I don't know why. Because that's the way it's pronounced, Janji. Whatever. Machine. Okay, so Machine is out. Machine Plus. Standalone. Now, the price point, they ain't giving it away. Now, I think it's $13.99. They ain't giving it away. So they're pricing it competitively on the high side, if you ask me. But I'm like, this is interesting, because for so long you just kind of thought that this, they were not ever going to do that. They were going to stay in that space of just being a controller. Well, I don't know if Akai Force, if they saw that, was like, hey, and that prompted them to take action, because essentially Force is like standalone push. So, you know, I'm thinking, you know, this could be interesting in this space of groove boxes. It really could, you know, for them to kind of, like I said, to make a standalone unit after all this time, this could really shake up some things. It really, really could. Now, I don't know if they, if they're going to make a cheaper version somehow, scale back some things to make a smaller one, if you will, like they did with the bigger, the studio, and then came out with the other one called the Micro or whatever it was called. I don't know if they're going to go that route to kind of be more competitive with the MPC One at that $6.99 price point. But Machine, I mean, Native Instruments sounds, oh my God, the sounds are amazing. So I could just only imagine that this groove box should be nice. Now we'll see. I don't know how advanced the sequencer is. Is it electron level sequencing? If it is, because if you match that level of sequencing with Native Instruments sound quality, then you got a killer combination. And so I think this is going to get real interesting. I can't wait to kind of see, and you know, see Loop Op do his thing with it when he shows it off and kind of reviews it. I can't wait to see that. I'm pretty sure Bo is going to get it. So yeah, so we'll see. We'll see. John G TV, I'm back every month, week, every year, every month. You see me. I'm here. Me and you, John G. It's a beautiful... Oh, wait a minute. I ain't done, John G. You ain't done yet. Intermission. Hey, okay, here we go. Is it me? It is me. It is me. So check this out. For all this time, I don't even know how long this thing been out. For all the time, Behringer, yes, I didn't even want to end the show on Behringer. I thought I was going to end the show on Machine. Behringer snuck in there again. Listen, Behringer, the RD6. I thought that was the TD3. So when I saw it, I just thought, whatever. I was like, damn, what's all about all these colors? Why they got, okay, they got more colors? Like, damn, they got a lot of colors. They really going in on these TD3s. Jeez, like, I'm like, okay. And then I'm looking at it, and again, because they're identical. So I can't even tell you what clicked. But something, I don't even know what it was. But finally, the light bulb went off. Like, wait a minute, what? And so, yeah, long story short, whatever. I look at it, I'm looking at the colors, like, man, so the purple one, I think that maybe that's what it is. I saw the word translucent. I'm like, wait a minute. I mean, you can see through and stuff. So I'm like, all right. And so the purple one caught my eye. That purple, I'm looking at it like, that looked nice. Oh, that's a drum machine? Yeah, so if, I'm just saying, hypothetically speaking, if I were in the market, I would be going for the purple one, the purple translucent. Fire the way it looks. Oh my god. So yeah, Behringer and the RD6. I don't know when the RD9 is supposed to be dropping. I was just checking out Sonic Talk today, and they were talking about the RD9 was supposed to had already dropped, you know, like this is the original Behringer that we know with the extreme long, you know, and I think they kind of corrected that, but RD9 is still lingering in that first round of forever rollouts. Like, we were promoted, but then you'll get it like 3 years later. We just wanted to make sure we y'all got y'all money ready, you know what I'm saying, whatever they were doing, I don't know. But after that, they kind of got on the ball and started saying, oh, we got something, or here it is type of thing. But yeah, so the RD9 is still in lag mode. I'm at this point, I'm guessing next year. If it comes out this year, great. But yeah, so the RD6, I believe that joint is going for what? Like 179, I want to say I saw it for. So, you know, that's for Behringer, I would expect it to be actually cheaper. However, what the reason why I'm interested, even the only reason why I would even really be interested in it is that it has individual outs. And the individual outs still, for me, that kind of means something. So at that price point, having individual outs, I think that's pretty nice. But even for Behringer, I thought 179 kind of felt on the high side, like it might have been one, like 149 maybe, but at 170, you still, it's less than $200. You're not gonna nitpick over a couple bucks. But I did initially, that was my initial thought. My thought was, okay, Behringer, you know, I guess that the days of they just setting the bar low is doing, that's gone. Like, they ain't finna just keep doing that, I guess, over and over. So, but yeah, it's the same size as the TD3, and they got the same colors. They got one that's yellow and black and silver, and but they do have some new colors: the translucent orange, translucent red, translucent green, translucent purple, and then again, like I say, the black, the silver, and that smiley face yellow. So yeah, go check it out. John G TV chiming in when I can, man. It's just a pandemic. I'm going through shit. I mean, life is crazy. Woo! John G TV!
Yeah. Which one? Monkey. It should be in the back.
Yeah, you see, John,